Hello and welcome to Shy Rye 3D. I'm Shy Rye, and today I'm going to teach you how to model basic primitive shapes. Primitive shapes are basic 2D and 3D objects. They consist of 2D and 3D models. And every complex model has these basic shapes. Our goal today is to understand 3D space and mesh by learning how to model these basic 2D and 3D objects. I'll be doing this video in parts and also in one big upload so you can choose how you consume it. I understand that this stuff isn't exactly the most exciting thing in the world, but I promised this tutorial video over a year ago, and by golly, I'm gonna make sure it happens, and nobody's gonna stand in my way. Not even you. Enjoy the video. Okay, so we got our Mortal Kombat style ladder system here. I'm gonna hit Shift A, go down to single vert, and click on add single vert. If you click the delete key on the numpad, you can zoom in on that. You can see we have a single vert. I'm gonna grab it and hold control and put it up and over to the left one blender unit. I'm gonna hit Shift D and copy that, or duplicate it, I mean. Connect them by selecting both of them and clicking F to make a line or an edge between them, and then with both selected, I'm going to hit E to extrude two blender units down. Then I'll just throw on some kind of quick material. I'll probably make it green or something. Actually, I know I made it green because this is all pre-recorded. Yeah, see, I thought about red, but I was like, nah. Shy Rye, just way too much red, man. Okay, so we have a perfect copy of a 2D plane. And it looks pretty good, if I say so myself. It's literally a carbon copy of it. We just made it from scratch, and that's what we're going to do with all these other objects on here as well. See, they deform the same way, everything. Okay, so now, if I'll stop playing with the planes, I'm going to grab everything and move everything up, just like the Mortal Kombat ladder. And now we're going to focus on the cube. I overshot it a little bit. There we go. So, we need to look at the cube as well. I do it with the other ones, but I guess with this one I didn't. I'm just going to copy or duplicate that plane and drag it down right next to my cube by hitting G and Z on the Z axis and dragging it down to where it's even with my cube. Then I go into my side view. I'm going to grab it and move it on the Y axis. Looks like a blender unit over 12 inches, whatever you have it set to. I hit E to extrude and hold control on the Y axis to drag it out. Two blender units to make a perfect cube. There we go. We're just flying through these. These are easy, guys. Come on. Before you know it, you're going to be modeling characters and doing all kinds of cool stuff, but for now, you know, we're just learning the basics. There ain't nothing wrong with it. I mean, once you get the solid foundation down, everything else is easy. I still struggle with really complex, like, objects and things like that, but you don't have to. I mean, you'll get there eventually. I'm still learning every day. Okay, so, enough rambling. On with the circle. We're going to look at this circle. I made it a simple circle because I didn't feel like putting in tons of lines and vertices. So, and plus this is just for a tutorial, so I'm counting 8 vertices around. So, I'm going to hit Shift A, Mesh, Single Vert again, Add Single Vert. Okay, we're in edit mode. So I'm gonna grab this on the Z axis and move it up one blender unit. Make sure it snaps by holding control again. In case, for some reason, some people still don't know it, you hold control and it snaps it to that grid in the background. Okay, Oh yeah, I went ahead and added a mirror modifier too, and I put it on the Z and the X axis. That way, it's going to mirror whatever I work from that middle point, if you can see that. So I hit Shift D and I duplicated that and moved it down and over one blender unit. Now I'm going to click on these two vertices and hit F to make a line between them, or an edge. Then I'm going to subdivide it. For me, I have it set up where I hit spacebar, and then I can search for whatever. But you have to go up to your user preferences and figure out what your search is. There's also a shortcut for subdivide. You can look that up on Google or anything else. I never could remember it for 2.8 on, so I just never used it. I just always searched. So I shift D'd and duplicated another vertice. Now I'm just kind of measuring to see how many squares up and over it is. So I hit shift E to make that vertice, and I'm just kind of eyeballing it to see what it looks right. And I go back to object mode and apply my modifier. Go into edit mode, and then I go back to continuing to move these points around because I'm never satisfied with anything that I do. Okay. I think I definitely settled on that one. That circle turned out to be just fine. Go ahead and give it that material. That circle is going to come into play a lot throughout the rest of this tutorial, by the way. I think all but one of, not like the rest of them, all use the circle as the starting mesh. So if you can make a circle, you can make all the rest of these as well. We're going to look at this UV sphere and see how it's made. It's a very simple UV sphere. I took it all the way down without losing that spherical silhouette that we're all used to. But if you can make this sphere, you can make, you know, any amount of, you can make a sphere with like 20 rings or 32 rings or whatever you want. Or you can just subdivide this one, it all works the same. Okay, now, so to make the sphere, I'm going to start with a circle. I'm going to shift D and duplicate it in object mode. Then I'm going to go to edit mode. In edit mode, I want to rotate on the X axis, negative 90 or 90, it doesn't matter. Oh, I did it in object mode, but you should be in edit mode. You don't ever want to rotate things and scale things in object mode. That's just a bad habit. But okay, so we're in edit mode. And I'm just trying to measure to see how far up I should extrude that. So I make sure my whole thing is selected by hitting A to select everything. And hitting E to extrude on the Z axis. To about what looks like it's even with the other sphere. It's just a hair short. It's halfway up that next cube. So I'm going to get it and bring my edges in a little bit. There we go. And it looks just about the same. Yep. We're good at measuring stuff. Then you just hit the E to extrude again. Bring it up to about that top. That top line, about right there. And then after you get that, you're going to hit, I think it's Alt-M for the shortcut, but I didn't use the shortcut, I used the search. So I hit search, and I clicked on merge, I hit on merge at center. I clicked on, excuse me, merge at center to make that point in the middle that we see at the top of the other sphere. After this, I think I'm going to go into face select mode and select that face and delete it. That way there's no face inside of it. I'm going to go back to my modifiers tab like I did before. Select mirror again, and this time it's going to be on the Z axis. And make sure you turn on, or the Y axis, I'm sorry. Turn on clipping. See, I rotated it earlier, so it changed the axis. That's why you shouldn't do that. But okay. So turn on clipping, now it's all one object, and we applied it in object mode, so now we have a perfect sphere. It's a little pointy, but we can smooth it out later if we wanted to. As you can see, you can select rings and loops and everything else just like the other sphere. So everything's the same. Moving on up the ladder, we have the cylinder. There's a lot of objects in real life that you can make out of using cylinders. Like, if you model the human body, it's pretty much a lot of cylinders stuck together, if you really look at it. We're just looking around the cylinder to see what shapes we can use to model it, and right off the bat, you can see that we have the circle at the top and bottom, and that's going to be a key shape we want to try to get in, and you'll see how simple modeling the cylinder is. If you can model the circle, or the sphere, you can model the cylinder. So we're going to shift D, that circle again, and bring it right down there. We're going to go into edit mode, select everything with A, rotate on the x-axis 90 or negative 90 degrees, whatever you want to do. We're going to bring it down by hitting G to grab on the z-axis. One blender unit. We're going to hit E to extrude on the z-axis. Bring it up about two blender units. And that's literally how we made a cylinder. Very simple stuff, guys. I can't talk the best, but I'm hoping that everybody can get through this tutorial and understand how these simple objects are made, and we can move on with it from there. We can model a bunch of cool low-poly stuff after this as well. Okay, so without rambling, here is a cone. A cone is the same thing. If you can model a circle, as you can see here, that shape, there's a circle at the bottom and a point at the top. If you can model this, you can model anything else here. So we're going to go back to an old reliable circle. Other than making it from scratch again, we're just going to copy what we've already done. Move it down there. Go back to edit mode and rotate it 90 degrees or negative 90. We're going to drag it down a blender unit. We're going to hit E to extrude and drag it up two blender units. Then we're going to Alt-M or merge at center again. And there you have it. Literally the easiest shapes ever. But if you're new to 3D modeling, this stuff is very important. Get your basics down first, guys. I swear, I can't stress this enough. Like, so many people try to jump into modeling things and they don't understand 3D space. And you need to understand 3D space before you model anything else. Now, here's the hardest shape we have to make. And it's a donut, essentially. A torus. Torus, however you want to say it. So if you look at it, I can see the circle shape here. There's all kinds of rings around this. Now, looking at it, you can see there's an outer ring and an inner ring. So first, the outer and inner rings. And yes, we're going back to our old reliable circle that we seem to just love. We're going to go ahead and zoom in on this. Go to edit mode and click R to rotate on the x-axis. I clicked Y for some reason. On the x-axis, 90 degrees. You can make it as big as you want to, but I was trying to model it directly after a default one, so I was trying to measure it. I was just looking at it. As you can see, it's a little smaller. The inside ring of that is, it fits well within that X. So I bring it over to kind of look at it in wireframe mode. So I look at it and I'm like, okay, so I scale this down. It was 0.8 and 0.7, somewhere between there. So I bring it down to, like, you know, 0.8. And now 0.7. Yeah, there we go. 0.7 looks a lot better. So I go back to material view after I figure it out. I went to the wrong shader. The wrong viewport, I mean. Shader. There we go. So now we have the inside ring of that donut shape. We're going to hit E. No. Yes, we're going to hit E to extrude. We're going to pull out about the middle ring, which its edges line up with the square. So just follow it like that. Then we're going to extrude one more time and pull it out about the same amount There we go, and it lines up pretty much perfect. I'm gonna delete this face in here because we don't need it. There we go. Don't need any of those extra faces. I shouldn't have had you do it like that, but we fixed it. It's okay. I just needed to select that middle ring, so I hit Alt and clicked on that edge and pulled it back up to match the other one. And now you see that donut shape. We're going to go back to our handy dandy modifiers tab, add a modifier, another mirror modifier. This time it should be lined up right, and it will be on the Z-axis. There we go. Now we're going to turn on clipping, tab out of edit mode, back into object mode. Then we should go over here. It looks perfect. Should go over here and apply the modifier now that we're out of edit mode. So click on that arrow, click apply, and there we go. We have successfully modeled every primitive shape there is in Blender or any other 3D program. Congratulations on finishing the Blender Basics course with ShyRai3D, and I truly appreciate your time. If you remotely enjoyed any of this content, feel free to like and comment and subscribe to either my BitChute or my YouTube channel. Yeah, with that being said, I want you guys to have a good one, and I'll see you real soon.